Thank you. So, work in progress, right? Denise, the end of this fugue, yeah? It's about in a little bit faster than the opening of the whole sonata, isn't it?
Yeah.
Huh? Yes. Yes, well, it should be. So it might be a good idea to have a look at the first movement and see how the tempis relate, because with that you see it's But anyway, let's have a look at the start. Of course, one of the difficulties of this piece is the tempos change all the time, and we have variety of adagios. We have adagio, ma non troppo, there is più adagio, there is andante, there is meno adagio. So, first of all, you need to find what the speed, kind of the central speed is, which is going to be probably adagio, ma non troppo. This is kind of the central speed. And then più adagio, meno adagio has to sit around it. So if we choose one speed that is going to be steady one, that is the beginning, yeah? And then we'll see how much we can deviate. But it's important to have something that, you know, holds you together. And of course, then the arioso will be in that tempo, in the tempo of the adagio at the beginning. Isn't it? So you've got to, if it's easier, you know, to think of the tempo of the arioso. Two. So how would be, that's the beat. One. Yeah? Can we now play the opening in that speed? Yeah, you see, so it's a little bit faster than you play it, yeah? You've got to remember the arioso will be in this. Now, look at what's interesting. This. And then it's sort of by itself. It doesn't belong to the first opening. It's some sort of question, isn't it, internal, but why? Yeah? So let's see, that the holding note, the pedal bass, yes, I think it's wonderful when to hear this, yeah? no, different sound. Arrived. Different sound. Magical. So ta ti ta and is a no, sorry, why I'm in it totally the wrong octave. T suddenly after this something a light coming into it, isn't it? Or something really much warmer, because this is very cold, you know, very distant. And then a T. Yeah? Let's see. Oh, good. And then what? Don't wash. Yes, place this. And. No, no, that's fine. Yes, because it's recitative. So what he wants to do is just to release the tension, I think, a little bit, you know, and maybe improvise. Huh? The ti, to, ti, to. Yeah. No, this is the question, isn't it? So first we heard the atmosphere, isn't it? That sort of state of a human, you know, what, how frustrated, lonely, I think, we can feel sometimes. And this is the question, and why you know, this is a monologue with yourself, isn't it? Come parlando, speaking, you know, saying, you know, why is this? Why is so life so unfair and lonely and, yeah? Can be, yeah, in this piece. Slow. Linger on this note, ta, 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 you know, ta, 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 and reply, ta, ta, and show me the in the triplet, the first note. You know, maybe not absolutely even in time, yeah? And a very typical sort of Beethoven's way of dealing with tragic moment, when there is the inner voice which is saying, why? There's always a question, why, I think, in Beethoven. And a reply that comes, you know, with orchestra, isn't it? This in the andante. Do, ci, to, to. Ci, to, to. And again, ti, ta. That's a human again. Ti, ta. Towards the major. Ta, 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 ta. Do, to, linger. Not fast. Adagio. And Don't crescendo yet, because you see, here we have no idea what chord we're going to go in. What are we going to? Is it going to be major, minor? This is where you see. So you're grabbing to the A flat minor, yeah. So, but at the beginning, you don't know. It still could turn into B major, and only here we know, you know, where the key is, yeah? Mm-hmm. Next, don't do gasps, it's straight. No, it's got diminuendo, that's it, you know, we've heard the color, we heard the key, now you have to clear up the space for an aria, yeah? You know, I wouldn't use your fourth finger, use third. It's fourth is hard to control on such soft dynamic. Third and sort of glued to, yeah? And go away. Yeah, okay, here you've got to really think singer. Got to really think singing, because what you do, you take breath every time before every note. You know, this is what I hear, another breath. So you take a breath and you stretch it. You see how many notes you can fit in on that breath. No, you see, that's all in one breath. Don't rush your accompaniment. That could have been together, you know, this together, so we hear chord and that note at the same time, yeah? No, you're breathing with your, you know, because you do this. Even visually, when I look at you and I see you do that, I think you take a breath. Yeah, you take a breath before E flat, and then you go to this point. Yeah. Yeah. Just it, you know, take it out, you know, of the key. That's it. Don't rush. Good. Disappeared the G. Left hand holds the tempo. It's not even about that. It's just, you know, if you're doing crescendo and then you suddenly, you know, go subito piano, you must think, how do I make sure that subito piano projects, you know, so that it doesn't disappear, yeah? So, yes, there is a little bit of time you take, but also you articulate that C. So, you know, so it's like, you know, it's very good idea to think of crescendo and then subito piano as falling off the cliff or nearly falling off the cliff. You know, when you come to the cliff and you're like, ah, and then you pull back. And I think that's the you know, pull back. Yeah, literally feeling that moment as if going over, but then stepping back. And that's C flat, you've got to really play it, you know, into the key so it's clear, not lose it. Yeah. One breath. You're rushing left hand, yeah? Do you hear it? Da, 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 ti, You see, there's no. Okay, you, okay. Can we change a finger at this point? Do you want to play second? Three, two, two. Yes, because it'll. You will have to step on it. Yeah, but T crescendo to the ends, and then join. No, 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 no. Because you won't take your hand off. Don't take your hand off. Just stretch it out. No. You must be going to that note, it, as if you were the crescendo would have that point. But more intense. Okay. Again, not rushing. Your left hand wants to get you moving. It needs space. You know, this area to sound, because it's an inner dialogue. Or monologue, rather. They can't have an inner dialogue unless you're completely mad. Yes? So, you know, at the beginning it came as a recitativo or a spoken voice, isn't it? And now it comes as a song, as an aria. So it's, you can take time. You know, so every note is said. Without rushing. Yes, very good. The only thing is I could add to it, you know, when you play left-hand triplets, you're a little bit obviously giving me one, two, three, one. You realize that? Yes. I think, first of all, don't relax your hand, because it's a bit, then, you know, it's just a little bit too free. You know, there's a tension there. So, you know, yes, go inside the key and like glue your fingers inside the key, and you just keep repeating. You know, because it also makes that line. You know, a little bit firmer. Yeah. Denise, you work from this part. If you just raise your wrist a little bit and go into the key. But fingers, yeah. Okay, let's try it together. Kind of in one line, you know, like singers, when they sing a cantabile line, you know, cantilena, they imagine a line going, so, rather than waves. So, do, do, do. Or if you were going, I don't know, playing a clarinet or something, you know, you just blow into the same, you know, place. Do, 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 do. Yeah? C flat, yeah? Okay. Don't rush. Good. Rush. Yeah, don't miss an opportunity to show me. Yeah, I need to hear what you feel about the next quarter. There is a little regret I hear in this, huh? In this change of key. Regret. Yes. When you're sorry for some, so sorry. But not rebellious regret, not strong regret. Regret that is. Exactly. Yes, and because, you know, like in every tragedy, there is a little bit of light, always, isn't it? So this is a regret, but it's gone, you know, it's been, you know, there's nothing you can do now. So there's a little, the little light is there, yeah? Let's try, right from maybe from the, yeah, from that, yeah, from that chord. You need the left hand. Don't rush. Yeah, and you know, looking at things like comparing. And this, you know, this is a lot darker, isn't it? There's a realization there is nothing I can do about it. Yeah? Yeah? So crescendo would really work nicely there. Yeah? No, don't make that voice. I mean, it's nice to hear it. It's important. Very yes, because it's
Do I need to show it?
Yes, but you need to choose different timbre for this voice. So if the soprano it's a certain question, isn't it? Where is this voice? It's more, I don't know, comforting somehow, isn't it? So we need a slightly maybe lighter sound. Softer, more human, more warmer, which is so. That's quite strong. Ah, but don't push that, yes? No, this is the next one. Yes, yes. Yeah. But stronger, stronger, don't be afraid. Oh, yes. Don't rush, you're getting faster. Left hand change, important. You know, that core will change direction, yeah? Tutti, tutti, even in piano, you know, but more, you know, yeah, octave needs to help your left. Very good. Just sort of as an afterthought, you've got to not stop brushing your left hand. Because you, I understand you want to move, but it, it's got to have this ta 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 ta. Yes, it's heartbeat, and it's also something that keeps. It's like keeps the reins. It's not shouldn't allow you to. Maybe, but there's some sort of heaviness, you know, there is some sort of tension in the left. It's not a song where you can sort of, you know, have a nice time, you know, beautiful. Yes, there is this ta 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 ti, there's something insistent. Yes, exactly, suffering, yes. I think left hand is very expressive here. Yeah? Yeah. All right, and then we start the fugue. So fugue is faster than adagio. That's the other thing, you know, we've got to still keep in mind, you know, we've got the adagio, yeah, and compare the speed. But this is it needs to keep moving, yeah. I thought you were a little bit in the slow side. Exactly. And the other thing is, it's a rising fourths. So rather than going ta ta ti ta, show me the rising ta ta ti ta toi. No, but it's three steps, isn't it? Ta 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 ti ta ta. Yeah? Yeah. Yeah, just be careful of the lower note. You don't want to, because it doesn't move anywhere otherwise. It's sort of sits on it, yeah. Yes, and left hand, because we want to keep the piano as well. You know, just don't wait, use any weight. Just articulate. Yeah, try it again. Good. Do you need to go mezzo forte straight away? Huh?
No.
And the other thing is, you know, would be nicer here the dominant tonic, you know, how it is. Mm-hmm. That's it. Yeah, because it comes in the left hand first. Yeah, so how you play the alto is of utter importance. See? Yeah, this one. Yeah, keep the alto really quiet because the left hand, the bass will become more important. Yeah, but alto is. Yeah? You see, this is the dominant tonic comes in here, yeah? Or arrival point anyway, yeah? So maybe from T. Diminuendo. Oh, you need for to do crescendo, you know, this. Yeah, need to show that bass line, you know. Let's go from here again. Diminuendo. it's too much, and it's not it's not, there's no line, you know, it's a little bit plonky. Yeah, always showing direction. Yeah, from where is a good place? Maybe from the same. Yeah. No. Ta li ra ra. You need accent there. And left. It's a steps. It's too heavy all the time. First step, second. Come on, show me. Yeah, too busy. Yes, that alto theme. Sorry, what am I playing? There's so much writing on the photocopy, I can't see. Yeah? Make sure your soprano, you see there's a piano above it. Yeah? So you can play the middle voice, say mezzo piano, mezzo forte even, I would say, you know, to bring it out, because that's a really tricky bit. Yeah? And lighter at the top. Try it. To you. Denise, very close to the keys. Get up on the first finger, you know, make it sound, make it project. Not this one, but the next one. You always collapse on your hand. Keep your hand. Keep your hand higher. Yeah, don't collapse your fingers. Raise. Yeah. Once more. You need to, because this time when you're playing, do you remember we talked about distribution of weight? So this time it's on this part of the hand. It's on the second finger, on the first finger. So think of them as tall fingers. Yeah, and a little bit firmer, kind of going into the key more directly. Yeah, your second collapses is a bit like that. You know, if you think of it as pointing finger, it is pointing finger, so you know, more straight. Yeah, it's too much. I mean, the thing is, when you have a accompanying voice sort of counter subject at the top, you can't help but you will always hear it. Exactly. Yes. So you've got to take care of the one that is underneath it. And I think you're playing first finger there. I think second is very good, because this is a natural ability of the second finger to point at something. So. Yeah, I mean, it's possible to do with thumb, but I think there's a big distance. I don't know. Yeah, can you swing your hand? And one, two. Yeah, light on the thumb. Yes. Can you try? No. You see. Okay. Try 1-1. Maybe that's better for you. Swing. Yes. 1-1. Better. Mm-hmm. That's better. I mean, in any fugues, you would need to practice to do the part playing. And of course, the bass at this point. Just articulate, so don't put any weight, because it will raise the whole, you know, dynamic level. And this is, can we continue a little bit from wherever it's convenient? Denise, can we try a chito chito? Would be nice to hear that tune. It starts from the chi to do, chi to do, chi to do. There is this theme which we must not lose. Okay, what I hear is too many beats. I hear ta ta ti ta ta ti. Can we organize it? Yeah, but again, not clear enough for me. And to, you see, that line prepares the theme again. Yeah, but clearer, that line. You play too much on the edges. Now it's the middle line we're after. It's really interesting, I find, because you use a lot of first finger on the top line. Mm-hmm. Or, I mean, on the top line of the left hand. But it's not, doesn't project, it doesn't sound. And I am really puzzled, because usually when you play something with the first finger, it actually sounds quite loud. But you managed to avoid this sort of natural quality of the first. you know, can you just sort of think that, you know, anyway, just use it as a part of your hand. Yeah, it's got weight in it, and you need that weight, natural weight. It's a big muscle on that first finger, huh? So try. No, more, lean more onto the thumb, more onto the thumb, just to try the left hand. Yeah, but I hear all the dee da dee da da too much. That's what's missing, yeah? Can you put that voice in the right hand and play to me between? No, 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 that voice in the right hand. So like that, between hands. Ah, okay, sure. No, 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 I'm just saying, so that you can hear it more clearly, can you just play that theme of the alto in the right hand? Just as without the upper voice. Yes, this, with the left hand together, and make the difference, dynamic difference. No, 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 no. You're playing the bass as it is, but right hand is playing what is not usually playing. Yeah, that's it. That's all I wanted. But can you make a bigger contrast? Because they sound almost the same dynamic level. Listen, exaggerate. Give me extremes. You know, forte piano. Yeah, and when you take this sound, you know, step a little bit on the key, you know, firmer. Yes, and that's what I want to hear. And a very precise, direct, firm sound in there, so that it can come out from these three voices. But you are using first, but it needs to be just raise your hand and try it. No, raise it into the thumb. You see, I still. Do you really want to articulate the bit? Lean onto the thumb. Yeah, better. Forte, forte in the top. Yes. Yeah. It's what we talked about when we were doing Bach. It's the distribution, how you voice different parts. About leaning onto one and the other, but you've got to find. I would really encourage you to practice it with the playing that the right hand. Yes, playing the right hand, because you've got to, first of all, get it into your ear. Exactly. You know, you have to sort of rewire your ear and then try it. And the other thing is, when you play thumb low, it's not quite the same power. So just raise it. And also, what helps a lot, even when you play it in one hand, is exaggerate. So stretch your extremes. So play that top forte, fortissimo, if you want, but the bottom is pianissimo. So you learn to do it, you know, to relax one part of the hand while really forcing the other one. Yeah. So don't be sort of too gentle with the sound. Sometimes a little banging the point. We'll drive the point home, because then you will hear it and then you can adjust. Does that make sense? Because a lot of the fugues, you know, has this issue of part playing. Exactly. It gets too busy and you've got to highlight it. Like, for example, this voice is important. Then the theme starts. And then look, we've got at the top of the soprano. This comes. Yeah. Can we pick up from that point, from the crescendo? Yeah. No, it's T and T dot E. Yeah, you know, this octave, subito fortissimo, it's a sort of a sign. But you need to think, it's not just and then I start. The start is on the G. And the G that has to get to C, do, T. Exactly.
How do you play it like this?
Octaves.
Yeah.
On the keys and sort of use your wrist to bring the sound, then it's never harsh. Because if you land from the top, it's a bit like, you know, sound of a falling brick on the ground, isn't it? Yes. Do you see what I mean? Then the sound is boomy and it's got good quality, not heating. Yeah. So the G starts. It show me steps. Yeah, but of course, when you have this much left hand, you have to do something with your right hand. So we've got edges, you know, because, you know, it's he's using quite a big range, if you think about this, and he gets as high as the D flat. It's expansive range, so it's not just the left hand that expands, you know, it's the right hand as well. Why so loud? Yeah, but not with an accent. Forte leading to the next bar. So it's not, because then you just, all you hear is an accent, but if you lead, if you phrase to the next bar, then we appreciate the forte. Does that make sense? Yeah? So let's go from the piano. Denise, where's the sound? Get it out of the key. That's it. And now. Reach. Yeah, don't fall on the upbeat, you know? Yeah, it's just heavy. It's like it doesn't get up. It has no energy. It's not no momentum. You see? And then again, whenever you have octaves that are always think, you know, what's happening in the other hand. And this is interesting. Can we go from forte? Because then there's a stretto. The stretto that is happening. You know what stretto is? Yes. There, and then we've got that voice. So we need to hear. But where was this? Again, look, you have your first finger, use it. Okay. Use that first finger. Yes? Improvisation, isn't it? What's next? Yeah? So not too soft, that chord, even though it's piano, because we still yet got to reduce the sound, you see? Yeah, so from the... Yeah, join. No, firmer that chord. Yeah, firmer so that each note comes out. And now, relax D. What was the tempo? Slower, wasn't it? Slower. You see, this is you have to build bridges. So have a look at what is the tempo of Ariosa. Where does it come back again?
Can I? Because there's the aria.
Yes.
So shall I start from the stesso tempo then? That part, take the other tempo from.
Yes, you have to take the tempo of Ariosa. Yes, but thinking about that, this is probably improvisation of Beethoven, you know. And then, I'm sorry, this is where it starts, you know. The tempo really starts when you start repeated chords. Yes, so here it's... I won't play major, I'm missing light. This is where we start the tempo of Ariosa, yeah? But until then, improvised, yeah? But when you have repeated notes, this is when the tempo starts. Okay, anyway, this... It's got a lot of similar things then, you know, coming back. And then you have the reverse fugue. I was really lost with the tempis in the second fugue. Really lost, because it's the tempo of the other fugue, isn't it?
No, it's not. It's even faster than
it gets faster.
No, I mean, the tempos are written there, so I don't know.
What edition do you use?
Henley.
The one that you have.
This is my teacher's edition. She wants me to put this one.
So we don't know which one it is.
So, no.
Okay. Now, but the question is, how do you start this tempo? And that wasn't for me something successful. So can we go? Can we build? Can we sort of maybe go? Just the end of Arioso into the new tempo. End of Arioso, when is a good... maybe from that... So this is the tenor. No, much more soulful. Yeah. Not too short, yeah, with some, yeah, the notes come out. Don't rush, this is your tempo, there is no. Yeah, but it's a bit dead fish in the water. You start in forte. Yeah? Yes.
It's not going up, it's actually going down.
Mm-hmm.
How can I show it in the melody line? Because it's like, it's going up, you know, each time, and then when it's going down.
Yes.
It's a reverse one.
So ti to ti to 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 and two and one and two ti to to. To the first beat. Yeah, but what I was going to say, you know, you've got to change the tempo immediately. You get to it gradually, huh? And answer.
Yeah.
Shape it. Yeah. Because it's built on the same intervals as your theme. 2/4. Listen, even though you have an accent, what am I doing? Yeah, the right hand continues through. Not. No, you fall into the accent. You don't spring out of it. Yeah, you see, there is a the tempo is a problem because this is. It's getting faster, but we're getting slower.
Yeah.
Beginning is from here. That's the tempo, isn't it? Not faster. Yeah? So when you get to 1, 2, 3. It's a little bit faster, then you pick up. But if you have to start too fast, as you did now, it gets too much, isn't it? We can't, and then we have to slow down.
So I should be a little bit slower?
Yes, but first of all, you need to start the theme slower.
Was it okay? No.
It was too fast, yes, it was too fast. That's why it's very important when you go from diminuendo is to get the right speed in your mind. You know, how fast is this is the theme? Okay? Yes, you have to figure it out. Exactly. You have to figure it out. It's not something which... thinking about... I think what would be helpful is if you play the theme, find a tempo for the theme, and then... see, okay, what's my meno allegro? Then what is animado? Mm-hmm. You know, so you know how the beat increases in pulse. So just putting, like 4 bars of this and 4 bars of this and 4 bars of this, sort of seeing how this grows. So you can structure a little bit. It doesn't sort of happen ad libitum. You know, an unplanned performance, maybe not a great idea, yeah? the ending was very good. It's the theme, again, just make sure that you really bring me to the chords that matter. Can you just go from the molto forte, maybe? No, don't rush. Yeah, it's very sort of celebratory, isn't it? The end of fugue is always celebration. If anything, of survival. Very nice. And don't be afraid, really, to say hooray. Denise, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.